the homiletic context.
You know, Ornette asked me when we were rehearsing.
We would stop in the middle of a piece, and he would say, "What were you doing right there?" And I would say, "I was just listening to you and playing." He'd say, "No, but you have to really know what you're doing.
You have to think about what you're doing. And know about how it works, what makes it work." And so I thought about that afterwards, and it was really right, because improvisation is very complex, very difficult. It's very emotionally draining. And the emotional draining part of it takes you away from thinking about what it is that you're doing technically. So from that point on, I started really thinking about what it was that we were doing together. I know before I had met Ornette, this was like in 1956 in Los Angeles, I was playing with different jazz groups in Los Angeles, playing at jam sessions, at jazz clubs, mostly bebop. And when it would come time for the bass to solo, sometimes I felt that I didn't want to play on the regular chord structure or the chord changes of the particular piece that we were playing. We might have been playing a standard tune or a blues or whatever. And sometimes I felt like I wanted to play on the feeling or the inspiration of the piece rather than on the chord structure. And I was really not free to do that, because when I tried to do that, the people that I was usually playing with were used to solos being played on the chord changes, and they were used to knowing where the soloist was in the composition. And they wouldn't know where I was if I would play on the way I felt about the piece. And when I did try it, that's usually what happened. It was a negative thing that happened. Musicians would be, they wouldn't know where I was in the piece. They would say, "Hey, what are you doing?" And so I always held back from doing that until I met Ornette. And he was doing that. It was a way of life with him. That's the way he improvised, was from the feeling of the piece and creating his own chord structure spontaneously, anew. Each time he played a composition, he would take his inspiration from that piece, or the feeling that he had for that piece, and he would create a new chord structure, and he would, by a process of modulation and intervals, phrasing, pitch, tonality. I learned more about listening playing with Ornette than any other person, because to play music with him, you have to listen to every note that he plays. And that's, we were all raised in that language, Don and Dewey and I, and Edward Blackwell and Billy Higgins. We played together for many years with Ornette, and we're very close to that way of playing. It's very important for us to be able to be free in our way of improvising. The other part of the concept is the human part of it, which is very close to the sound of the earth, or the sound of the human, or the sound of whatever it is that music is, whatever it is that life is. It's an acoustic sound. On my particular instrument, I play on gut strings, because the gut strings enable the instrument to sound the way the maker of the instrument meant for it to sound. It's a wood sound. And the gut strings, as opposed to a lot of bassists play metal strings, and that's more of a metallic sound. But part of the sound of each instrument in this music is that a musician, and it's really phenomenal when you think about it, a musician hears music a certain way when he's creating or she's creating. And to be able to play your instrument the way your ears are hearing the sound of it is a very important thing. For instance, what I'm trying to say is that Charlie Parker could play anyone else's alto saxophone, and that alto saxophone would sound the way his ears were hearing the music. And the same with every other instrument. It's whenever you hear Bud Powell touch the piano keys, you know right away that it's Bud Powell, because he is able to make the instrument sound the way his ears hear music, which is really a great gift and very important to the music. A lot of people have different concepts about the harmonic concept, which is what Ornette calls the way. And he has, I have music that he's written, exercises that show and illustrate what the concept is. He's always after me to write a book about the way the bass is, mm-hmm. functions in that music. Before I do that, I want to really learn more and more and grow more and more in the music and experience it more. But Don is right. I think all of us probably see everything about the concept of improvisation very close to each other, and yet when we explain it in words,
Yeah.